subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed Hajar alayhi salam with a child. And this was the first child of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ibrahim alayhi salam, now, as you know, he was moving, he was giving da'wah, he was having debates with kings and being thrown in fires and all of this that he was doing. And at that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't give him a child. And he, imagine, it must have been hard. Like, you know, you are a Nabi of Allah, you are a Rasul, you are يعني, Ibrahim, and he's from the greatest, the best known Anbiya. And Allah didn't give him a child for this whole time. And that teaches us something, to be patient when Allah writes something in Qadr, because Allah wrote something for him that was best for him, but he had to wait for it. Now he's old. And in that old age, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses him with a child. And this child, as we know, will grow to be a Nabi of Allah as well. So not just a child, but a Nabi, a very pious child, Ismail alayhi salam. Now he has a wife and a little child. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders him to take them to Mecca. At this time, there is nothing in Mecca. Yani, there is no building, there is no built Kaaba. What is correct is at this time, there was no building of Kaaba. Was it a holy place? Yes. From the time of Adam alayhi salam. Was it built up? No. Nobody lived there. There was no well of Zamzam there. There was no greenery there. There were no date trees or... if you've been to Mecca, the landscape is harsh to begin with. So now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered them to go to this one spot. Right? Now this is another test. So, he takes Hajar alayhi salam and Ismail. Now, what I want to clarify. We find a lot of ulama and a lot of du'at and a lot of books. They say that Sara alayhi salam, she had a jealousy with Hajar alayhi salam. That Sara was jealous of Hajar alayhi salam, because Hajar, yani, first was a servant to her, and now it became a co-wife, and then Allah gave her a child, and Sara then. All of this, I cannot find any authentic evidence for. Most of these ideas come from Israeliyat. They come from the narrations from the Yahud and Nasara and things from the people of the book before Islam. There are some mentions in Mawquf Rawayat, yani from Sahaba and things, but I found all of them to be weak. And it contradicts what is in the Sahih Hadith that will come, inshallah, when Ibrahim alayhi salam is walking away. So this concept is incorrect. Sarah alayhi salam is a very pious woman. She's not going to tell her husband to take a co-wife and leave her in the middle of a desert just because she's jealous. She's the one that told him to marry her. La, this is the Amr of Allah, this is the order of Allah. And Ibrahim alayhi salam is a responsible husband and father. He's not going to throw one wife in the desert because the other wife is jealous. And these are things we have to clarify, because we hear a lot of du'at and a lot of seerah lessons and they're saying this, but where is the evidence? And look at the implications you're making from it. La, what we find in the clear Sahih Ahadith, and inshallah we'll go over them as today inshallah, is that this was an order of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordained that Mecca would become populated. Mecca would become the center for Hajj. It would be the center where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be born there. So how would he be born there if Ismail alayhi wa sallam didn't go there? So here what is correct is that this was not due to jealousy or any kind of infighting that had nothing to do with it. What it was is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to take his young wife and child to Mecca. And he did. And he did not tell them why they're going. And this is something amazing. When you have a wise and pious leader, whether it's in a household, whether it's in a community, whether it's in a khilafah, whether it's in... It is not upon them to have to explain everything to everybody. يعني ابراهيم عليه السلام didn't have to explain, you know, we're going to go to Mecca and I'm going to leave you there and I'm going to leave you 30 dates and these many this much water and then I'm going to be when are you going to be back. No, he said we're going, that's it. And Hajar alayhi salam didn't ask, she went. Look at the great example you have in her. So they went on this huge journey. Now imagine from Sham to Mecca at that time is a very harsh journey to begin with in a desert environment. There's danger, there are bandits, I mean, all this kind of stuff. They get there, there's nothing. Not even like it's not even like, you know, like when people are stuff about this, why you shouldn't watch cartoons about the seerah and things like this or movies and things, because it gives you an image that's incorrect. Like people watch that message movie and then they think of some kafir actor every time they think of Hamza radiallahu anhu. And you cannot compare to the ru'ab of Hamza radiallahu anhu. Or some actor from Qatar now, we think of him as, alhamdulillah, I never watched it, but Umar ibn Khattab. No, Umar Khattab, his status is something else. So you think it's like the sand dunes and desert. It wasn't. This is hard rock desert. Mecca is mountains and rock. So you're in this place, not a human being, not a tree, no water. Ibrahim alayhi salam puts them down, sets them up, leaves them few dates and things, nothing much. And he starts to walk away. Doesn't say a word. Subhanallah. And when you think of Hajar alayhi salam, you know, when you go to Mecca and you go sa'i, think about these things. What a test. I mean, for our sisters today, imagine. Now, just to give some context, brothers, don't take your wife today and leave her in a desert. Allah didn't give you a wahi order for this. Okay? Don't make an excuse now. Some of the brothers, I'm going to go 40 days, khalas, I'm leaving my wife, no food, no money, letter back from the neighbors. Ibrahim alayhi salam did it. Ibrahim alayhi salam had a wahi from Allah. Did you have wahi? No, then don't do it. Don't apples and oranges, understand your place, right? But at the same time, there is an aspect here of tawakkul that we should learn from. And even if we don't do it at the level of Ibrahim alayhi salam, but at the same time, if your husband, if your son, if your father is going to go do something for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if he does his best to provide for you what he can, then also be patient with it. As Hajar alayhi salam, I mean the example that you have. Hajar alayhi salam, she starts to ask Ibrahim, it's only natural. I mean, Ibrahim alayhi salam just starts walking away. He doesn't say anything to her. He just starts walking. And she's like, who are you leaving us to? There is nobody here. There are no people. There's no food. There's no gardens. There's no water. A woman by herself and a little baby, a breastfeeding baby. Who are you leaving us to? He doesn't answer. Why? It's the wrong question. Like today, imagine. It's the wrong question. So she realizes that. And then she asks, is this the order of Allah? This is Sahih Hadith. I looked at the Asanid today. So don't... She said, is this the order of Allah? He says, yes. Now this is a dalil that this had nothing to do with jealousy between wives. Because here he told her, sarihan, clearly, yes, this is the order of Allah. She says, in that case, Allah will not abandon us. Tawakkul, amazing. A woman by herself, with a breastfeeding child, no food, no weaponry, men could attack, they could rape, kill, pillage, you got Bedouins around, you got all kinds of dangers, but she realized if it's the Amr of Allah, khalas, Allah is enough for us. This is a woman. Wallahi, our men don't have this iman today. Our men are not rijal today. They may be males, but they're not men. Everybody's scared, everybody's... Hajar alayhi salam, she's like, you know what? If it's order of Allah, Allah is enough for me. I don't need anything from you, go. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he walks until they cannot see him. And this is very important. Because he's not, na'udhu billah, this is na'udhu billah, some of the people, they make kufr by saying things that they don't realize they should say. There is some du'at, may Allah protect us. This is why I don't recommend you guys watching anybody's videos unless you know them to be upon the kitab or sunnah. Some of them, they said, na'udhu billah, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he was a deadbeat dad, he just left. And this is kufr. La, this is kufr. To call a Nabi something like this takes you outside the fold of Islam. Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't just leave his wife, and this is an order of Allah. And he has those feelings. Imagine, this is his wife. And this is his one child that he had after all those years in dua and asking Allah. How difficult of an order of Allah is that? Imagine one of us is told by Allah though, that even though, don't get any ideas because there's no more wahi coming down from Jibreel alayhi salam. I don't want one of you guys to be like, I got wahi. Because our brothers will handle you here, man. They'll take you outside and set you straight. But if Allah did test one of us like this, small baby, breastfeeding, young wife, leave them in a desert with nobody, walk away. How difficult would that be? So Ibrahim alayhi salam has those emotions. It's not that he doesn't have those. So he goes to a place where they can't see him because he doesn't want them to become weak by seeing him. And he's making dua. And this dars, I didn't want to go too deep into the story because I really want to get to the part about Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when you have time, go and look at the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and it's mentioned repeatedly in the Quran. I was looking to the different ayat. And it's not at one time. This is a mistake people think. Why? I'll give you a dalil quick, and I'm not going to go deep, but inshallah those brothers who have the love, they will go and look it up themselves. Sometimes it mentions baladan. Baladan, balad, without alif lam. Nakara. Baladan. Sometimes it's al-balada. Al-balada here is ma'rifa. In the Quran, same dua, same type of dua from Ibrahim alayhi salam. So I looked up why. Why is one time nakara and one time ma'rifa? One time it's just baladan without the alif lam. One time it's with the alif lam. And the tafsir that I found authentically is that the first one is nakira because at that time there was nothing built. And the second time is when he came back and he made dua again, but now buildings had been built, so alif lam was added. And something beautiful that most people don't think about. So that means Ibrahim alayhi salam kept coming back. I found 8 different times that is documented of him coming back, and it could be that he came back many more times. So he didn't just leave them. So when he has them there and he gets where they cannot see him, he starts to make dua. And it's beautiful dua, and it's mentioned in the Quran and with different alfaz. Look it up. But making dua for them to have aman, to have peace, to have the best of fruits and foods from all over the world, and for the people to go there and to establish it and to love to go there. And it's so beautiful that when you think about it today, the dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam is come to in front of us.